noisy welcome for the return of European competition to Old Trafford. Tonight's UEFA Cup first-round tie brings Ajax Amsterdam, 16 times champions of Holland, 7 times cup winners, 3 times winners of the European Cup. Ruud Krol, who played in all 3 of their European finals, captains the side, and it's the goal he scored in Amsterdam that gives Ajax a 1-0 advantage for the first leg. United's attacks will be spearheaded by young David McCreary, 19 last week, because Stuart Pearson there, England international striker, failed a fitness test on a hamstring injury this morning. So the United side will be the one that ended last Saturday's game, but as that was a 3-1 victory in the Manchester derby away from home at Main Road, that's a team that will not be lacking in confidence. Alex Stepney is the only survivor of Manchester United's European Cup victory in 1968. He recently completed 10 years at Old Trafford, and at the age of 34, he's playing as well as ever. Ajax's most experienced player is Barry Hulshoff, who will be 30 tomorrow. He played in their 3 European Cup successes, and in the final they lost in 1969. Otherwise, today's lineup is mainly notable for its relative unfamiliarity and the breakthrough of a few youngsters. John Duisbarber is only 20, so is Lalling, and Frank Arnesen, a Dane, will be 20 tomorrow. The officials tonight are all from France. The referee is Monsieur Conrad, and he's assisted by Monsieur Baku and Monsieur Didier. And this is Ajax attacking the goal to our left, there in an all-green strip. These two teams qualified for this competition by finishing third in their respective first divisions last season, and currently they both lie third in their respective divisions this season. Greenoff's ball played wide and the first foul of the game. Culprit was Duisbarber, youngster who stuck so tight on Pearson in the first leg. It'll be interesting to see what role he adopts in this game. Koppel with the hands raised, asking for 10 yards. Had 6 men queuing for the cross. It was only a fraction wide from McCreary. Goalkeeper came and lost it. Shrivers never really seemed likely to get to it. Came for the punch, but was beaten on the jump. Lewitsch, a lovely dummy. Chaos, and the first time shot by Erkens was well wide. And Erkens. Makara. Greenoff breaking beside him. Makari's run coming to an end when he mishit the pass. Houston. Interception by Hulshoff. Ling. 2 men supporting him. Hales put through the middle with a very good ball. And Stepney out fast. But it was a lovely through ball by Ling. Hales running onto it. There's the through ball from Ling. Hales runs on. And Stepney has come out fast. And saves well. And here we are back with Nicol. Gets a foot to it. Hill lost his man well, mishit the shot, and it could fall for McCreary, but it was blocked. Blocked by Arnesen. Looked as though McCreary might have some luck then, but Arnesen got in to stop it. Came back off the defender, and Arnesen it was who turned and stopped the shot from McCreary. Greenoff coming forward again, this time spreading it out for McCreary. Rotten, Kales. Ling waiting on the far side. Erkens there if he needs help, but he's going outside his man. Still got Houston to beat. Arnesen calling for a short chip. Ling has got round his man and pulled it across well for Hales. And against the crossbar, and just over. came back to Arneson the second time. This is Ling, eventually fools Houston, plays a good cross. Up goes Hales, and it beats Stepney's fingers here, comes back off the bar, and Arneson can't quite get over it. Just has to see it drop past the angle. Notton. Chaos. Notton again. Van Dort. He's away from Koppel. It was a deflection off Jimmy Nichols' studs, and it's a corner. First Ajax corner of the game. Hulshoff coming forward. Pretty useful header of the ball. Aim for Hales, and a good catch by Stepney. Beautiful corner. Struck well by Van Dord, right onto the head of Hales, and that glancing header was aimed for the post, but Stepney caught it well. Koppel. Koppel so far has not got much change out of Van Dord, but that time he got a free kick for obstruction. 3 minutes to go to half time. Nickel. Goalkeeper's punch is effective again. Ajax streaming up, but no offside. Hill, well stopped by the goalkeeper, but the parry! The original shot as the defence were coming out, looking for offside, but the trap was well beaten there. You could see Ling playing Hill onside, and Hill's hard shot came back off the keeper's body, and Macari, following up, smacks it into the net. One all, 2 minutes before half-time. 1-0 in this game, one all on aggregate. Hulshoff's header. Daly, pulls off again, Hooster, Macari, Hill. Hill's cross covered by the goalkeeper this time. Krom. Very long. Houston's header. Now green off. Erkens. Ajax ball. Erkens. Ring. Such a lot of confidence on the ball, this young Ling. And that's a useful ball for Gluitsch. Arneson. He's lost it. Houston. McCreary for McElroy. And on for Daly, but Krull is coming across. He'll need the goalkeeper. Very cool play by the Ajax skipper. And we're now in the extra time that the referee has added on in this first half. He's just had a check with his watch. Stoppage of about a minute, that's all. Erkens. Speculative shot, easily fielded by Stepney. And there's the half-time whistle, and they go in with Manchester United leading by 1-0, thanks to Lou Macari's third goal of the season. And that, on aggregate, balances the teams up at 1-1 and sets things up for a tremendous second half. Join us again in a few moments. Tap the Stretford end goal to our left. Lou Macari to Greenough. May well be that playing it around at the back will tempt Ajax out in the second half in a way that it didn't in the first when they were in front. Have been drawn against English opposition in European competitions, and they could be in some trouble here. McCreary. United just couldn't sort themselves out a shooting chance. Then fouled by Houston. Chance that United couldn't quite take. Shot first of all from McCreary, from McElroy, and then by McCreary, both blocked. Erkens. Turned back by Nicol. Still lying well up, so Greenough may have to go it alone. Shriver's did well to smother that. Greenough kept coming, and sooner or later the shot was inevitable. And there it goes with his right foot, which is the powerful one, and Shriver smothers. Just too far ahead of Lurch. Houston. Houston again. This is only the sixth corner of the game, four of them to Manchester United, and that one easily headed away by Hulshoff. Ling. Nicholls' header falls nicely for Arnason, and he's just got Stepney to beat, and he couldn't do it. The Dane really didn't seem to know what he wanted to do then. Didn't look like a confident run at all. Came back off Nicol to him. And after he'd gone past him, you could almost see him slowing down while he tried to make up his mind. And it was a rather half-hearted poke that Stepney got at the second attempt. Macari. Well-meant ball, but it didn't reach him. McCreary. Same towards McElroy's head, but Ajax have got it away again. Koppel. Room to go outside his man, but he's come back inside for the left foot. And again, Shriver's punches. Handball. Ajax appealing for handball. I think the justification. But it's all academic because the shot was over the top. And we're going to have a substitution now. Manchester United are going to take Gerry Daly off. And Arthur Augustin is coming on in his place. Daly hasn't been his usual self at all this season. And certainly hasn't looked entirely in touch in this game. So Augustin, with only a handful of previous appearances, comes into the game. Takes up position at full-back, which is where he usually plays. And Houston goes into the middle of the back four, and Greenough goes into midfield. It's too far ahead of Arnes. But it's a corner. Nicol got the angle wrong, trying to pass back to Stepney. So Nicol on the near post. Houston, the tall bearded defender coming up, because he's such a good header of the ball. Will he get to this one? Yes, he does, nicely. Nodded it in, but no one following. And the referee gives the free kick to Manchester United for a foul by Deuce Barber. Bakari wants to take it quickly. Houston. Hill robbed by Gluitch as soon as he'd got the ball. Orbiston's throw. McElroy cannot turn away from Hulshoff. But what can Hill do now? Lovely dummy, and over he goes. And the referee waves play on, and the goalkeeper turns it over for McElroy. Hill was looking for a penalty then. But the referee reckoned it was a dive. Yes, I think he was already taking off, and the referee's decision was good. So was McElroy's shot, and so was Shriver's save. Good header away by Gluitch. Goalkeeper swallowed that one quite comfortably. Deuce Barber. Fails. Nicol's cross. Well controlled by Koppel. Greenough going in and put into the net by McElroy. Shot, but Stepney perfectly positioned on the edge of the 6-yard area. Orbiston now to Houston. Steve Patterson is the player who's going to come on. Young defender. Greenough. Nicol. Bakari. Good hook on the turn. Shriver's decided he couldn't afford to let it go. And Manchester United are going to take off Gordon Hill. Steve Patterson. And just to his left is Meyer, coming on as substitute for Ajax. So Patterson into action for the first time for Manchester United. Well-built young Scot, 6'1½", 13½ stone. And Gert Meyer, 25-year-old, coming on as substitute for Ajax in place of Arnes. the direction didn't fall Houston. That's Meyer, the Ajax substitute. Showing a bit of pace down that flank too. And the low cross isn't really got away. Buchan got it, and then it ran straight onto Houston's feet. And there was a muddle there. This is the cross from Meyer, cleared by Buchan, but it hits Houston there. And Hales couldn't take advantage of it, put it out for a goal kick. Barber beaten by the bats. Steve Coppell for Manchester United, and a good shot. And once again, goalkeeper relies on his fists, but he seems to know what he's doing when he's punching, because there's a real hammer from Coppell's left foot, and a hammer away by Shrivers. Shrivers, Houston on his near post, looking for the back header very well. Picked out of the air from Makari's header by Shrivers. Who Makari it was who got in the second header. Alderston, referee checking his watch, 30 seconds left on mine. Coppell, this is the right end for Manchester United. They can afford to play possession up here. 15 seconds to go. Out of play for a throw-in. Referee again looks at his wrist. Tommy Cavanagh on his feet at the touchline. And there is the final whistle. And Manchester United's Red Army is on the march again. Goals here by Makari and McElroy, giving them a 2-0 scoreline and a 2-1 aggregate. And so they pick up where they left off on May the 15th, 1969, when AC Milan knocked them out in the semi-final of the European.